It's easy in 3JS to hook up the mouse, keyboard, and other devices as interactive controls for objects in a scene. We've been doing this all along with demos such as the robot arm. There's much JavaScript code to draw upon for getting inputs connected to programs, such as the DatGUI library for sliders. However, up to this point we've had little direct interaction with our virtual worlds. By direct interaction, I mean using the mouse to click on the world itself and change its appearance. The main direct interaction so far has been using the mouse to move the camera. As an example of another direct interaction, in this demo by Max Ogden and James Halliday, I'm clicking to remove blocks or add them. Programs can be seen limiting without these sorts of direct interactions with what the user sees. Even when moving around the scene with the mouse, in many demos it's as if we're a ghost. We can walk through walls or drop through the floor, there's nothing stopping us. By instead performing what's called collision detection between objects and having the program respond to those collisions, we can create a more believable world. We can also use physics to determine how our actions and the movements of other objects change what we see. If you've played any computer game, you know how various button pushes and so on are tightly tied to what you see on the screen. How the world reacts to inputs such as these is often shown through animation techniques of one sort or another. Up to this point, we've mostly been ignoring this fourth dimension, time. Once we start changing elements in our scene over time, we're performing animation. Animations can also be run in their own right. Streams flow down a hillside, people walk past you in a marketplace, the sun sets over ocean waves. Animation, such as shown in this demo by Daniel Heed, gives a scene life and a sense of engagement, even when there is little interaction. What I'm going to cover in this unit is a sampling of interaction and animation techniques, so let's get going!